This is the most vicious mother I have ever seen. She made her daughter take unknown pills every day. For 18 years, Lisa thought these pills were mandatory because she was asthmatic, diabetic, and even partially disabled. But one day she found out something. She picked up the package her mother had brought home. She surreptitiously took some candy bars that her mother wouldn't let her eat. But then she looked at the bag and froze. She actually found the medicine she always took, and it said it was prescribed for her mother. Lisa didn't care about that. After all, it was her own mother who could care less about this. But at the end of the day, Anna brought the medicine to Lisa. Lisa hesitated, but took it anyway. But lying in bed, she thought something was wrong. In the morning, she looked at the pills in her hand and fell into a deep thought. Lisa was an academic who was very good at physics and chemistry. He used an arm extender of his own invention. He used an arm extender he invented to remove the bottle of pills from high up. On his way out, he ran into the mail car. He rushed downstairs to pick up the mail. When he opened the door, he ran into his mother. Lisa had been waiting for her college acceptance notice, but every time the delivery came, her mother took it first. She said she would have told Lisa if it was an acceptance notice. The girl went back to her bedroom and stared at the pill bottle. The more she thought about it lately, the more wrong it was. After thinking about it, she started to tear the bottle with her hand. There was some dirt in the cap of the finger. Sure enough, the package was torn open, and there was a different kind of medicine inside. At night, her mother came into the house with medicine and water. She pretended to take the pills as if nothing had happened. When the woman left, she spit out the pills. She thought it must not be a good thing. When the woman fell asleep, she carefully walked to the living room, opened the computer to find out what kind of medicine it was, but the internet was already down at home. Lisa was confused. She didn't know that Anna was there watching the whole thing. The next day, he picked up the phone and called the pharmacy. She didn't realize that the pharmacy had already been called by her mother. She hung up the phone in a hurry. Then she dialed a random person's number. The person actually helped her find out the name of the drug. The person on the phone told her it was a red pill for heart disease. It was obviously not the same kind of pill as his green one. Lisa hung up the phone and was completely baffled. She took the opportunity to go to the movies with her mother and ran away for the day. She found a drugstore on the street. She took out this unknown drug and wanted to know what it was. What was the drug that her own mother had given her for so many years? But the next words of the woman horrified her. What kind of medicine is for animals? It's a drug that makes the lower limbs of small dogs and cats paralyzed. At that moment, her mother also came to her. He dreaded to think that his own mother would harm her. She might be the cause of his disability. Suddenly, the woman took out a small needle and stuck it directly in her leg. Lisa's vision blurred and she passed out. The mother held her daughter and slowly calmed her down. The next morning, Lisa woke up. His mother had prepared breakfast for him on the table. He opened the door in his little wheelchair. He couldn't twist it several times. It turned out that the outside had been secured by a woman with a wooden stick. He was devastated. She didn't know what was going on. Lisa then opened the window, ate breakfast for energy, took out her welding equipment. After holding the blanket in her arms, then lifted a glass and took a sip of water. He climbed out of the window on his own hands, with water in his mouth and pouting. He climbed forward little by little. It was dangerous, but she had to figure it all out. It took him nearly 2 hours to climb outside his mother's window. A small power plug that small iron head became red directly on the glass. A number of lines were seen. Small glass cracked several lines. Then a mouthful of water sprayed on it. The glass exploded. Put a sheet on the window to prevent herself from being stabbed. She counted every step, but then her asthma got the better of her. Quickly went back to her room and found the spray. It came back to life in a flash. He drove his wheelchair downstairs and accidentally rolled underneath. At that moment, he found that he could feel his toes because she hadn't taken that medicine for days. So it was really her mother who was causing all this. She got up on the floor with all her might, got into the wheelchair and turned around, pushed open the door, and this time he was leaving. Halfway through the wheelchair, she saw the delivery truck. The truck driver saw the girl get out of the truck. He told the driver what had happened to him. He was about to get in the truck and run away. By now, Lisa had driven back. The woman got out and asked the driver for her child, where also threatened to call the police. But the driver was obviously a smart guy too. He did not care about that directly to send Lisa to the car. I didn't expect to get down just now. The small needle was stuck directly in the man's neck. Lisa was scared in the car. Is this still her mother? She woke up in the basement, where she had been confined. She found countless letters of acceptance to prestigious schools inside. Her grades had been accepted by so many prestigious schools. Every time her mother grabbed the envelope with her, just to keep her out of the loop. He found something even more horrible in another box. She was actually not Lisa's real daughter. It turned out that Lisa's daughter was born with asthma and paralysis. It didn't take long for his baby to die, so she took a baby from the hospital. The baby was drugged to make it look like her own daughter. Disabled. Asthmatic. Diabetic. She kept her in captivity for 18 years without any contact with the outside world. Anna came in and knew that she couldn't stand it anymore. Now this daughter is no longer hard and soft. She grabbed a needle and tried to give him another shot. Lisa dragged her handicapped leg to the warehouse and hid. He looked at the shelves of poison and had a plan. When Anna opened the door, she drank the poison straight from the bottle because she knew this woman wouldn't let herself die. Sure enough, she was rushed to the hospital to have her stomach pumped. But when she woke up, the woman was waiting for her outside the room. She now had something in her mouth and couldn't speak. When the woman left, she signaled the nurse to write. But halfway through writing, the nurse was called away in an emergency. It turns out it was all Anna's doing in the other room. She pushed Lisa and started to walk out. On the way, she kept signaling with her eyes that the passersby were useless. Inside the ward, the nurse came back and found her unfinished writing. The hospital police quickly attacked and stopped the woman. She took out her gun and tried to fight. One shot to the shoulder. 10 years later, Lisa came to see her mother in prison. Her leg didn't heal completely, a disability that would stay with the woman for the rest of her life. She told Anna she'd been to see her grandparents. She talked to her mother like a daughter, but the look on Lisa's face was one of horror. Suddenly, Lisa's mouth began to move. She spit out three little pills.
I love you, Mom. Now open wide.